After you install Undetectable, enter your username and password for the license. Make sure that you enter the username and password from the license. It should not be from the account on the site. You can change the password in the license settings on the site undetectable.io. There are two types of licenses, solo plan and team plan. Licenses are not linked to your device, so you can install the program on any number of devices, but depending on the tariff, you will have a limit on the number of active copies. After you log into the program, you can see that the program is divided into four sections. 1. Menu. 2. List of profiles, search, filter, and sort by them. 3. Profile settings area. 4. Profile information. The menu consists of the following items. 1. New profile. 2. Mass creation, under development. 3. Proxy manager, under development. 4. Tag manager. 5. Profile manager. 6. Settings. Description of the program settings. The main tab displays the login from the license. It's possible to change the program language. Russian and English are supported. The color scheme's changing is currently under development. After changing the language, some of the elements may not be translated. Restart the program to fix it. About the program tab displays the current version and allows you to check for updates. As you can see, the latest version is currently installed. Restart the program to update, and you will be prompted to update to the latest version. Let's create a new profile. The first step is to set the profile name and set the necessary tags. This is followed by 5 tabs with profile settings. On the first tab, the main profile settings, which cannot be changed after saving. 1. In the configuration filters, select the operating system and browser that we need. 2. Let's select the config that interests us from the list of configurations. At the beta test stage, each license is issued with 50 configurations of various systems, the latest versions of browsers. The list of configurations is updated periodically. 1. Next are the fields for changing, the user agent and the screen size. We highly recommend using the standard user agent from the configuration. Only when using the standard configuration parameters can we guarantee maximum security of the profiles. However, the ability to modify these parameters has been added due to numerous requests from our users. Therefore, if you're going to change the default user agent, it's important to take into account the compatibility of the new user agent with the configuration. The next step is to configure the primary and secondary languages. The accept language header can also be modified. On the next tab, let's configure the proxy. 1. Choose the HTTP or SOCKS5 type. 2. Set the IP, port, username, and password. Proxy input fields support formatted input. On the network fingerprints tab, you can configure WebRTC geolocation and time zone. WebRTC. 1. Enabling WebRTC substitution. 2. Define a public IP. 3. Generate a random local IP or leave it inactive. In WebRTC, we recommend you always enable the public IP and disable the local IP. According to the statistics, this is the most common option. There are the geolocation and time zone settings below. Click on the Max Mind button to fill in these parameters quickly. For detailed geolocation settings, you can use the built-in map. In the upcoming updates, we'll add the ability to install all network fingerprints based on the proxy automatically. Let's go to the System Fingerprints tab. On this tab, you can configure masking or adding noise to the following system prints. 1. Canvas. Add noise or use the system settings. 2. Audio context. Add noise or use the system settings. 3. WebGL metadata. Apply a mask or use a system mask. 4. Hash the WebGL image. Add noise or use the system hash. 5. Window size. Emulate or use system size. Finally, set up cookies. In the Import tab, you have the option to import cookies. The supported format is JSON only. you can import files or text. When you are importing files, you can select several at once. Clicking on the Netscape to JSON button opens a converter where you can convert cookies from Netscape format to JSON. Importing the selected files. On the Edit tab, there are following functions. 1. Search by cookies. 2. Updating the list. 3. Deleting and viewing each file. 4. Export cookies in JSON format. 5. Clear all cookies. 6. Number of files. On the right, you can see detailed information about the profile settings, add notes, and change the start page. For convenience, after creating a profile, the home page will change to the last open tabs. In the lower part of the program, there are buttons for saving and launching the browser. 1. Quick start. Start the profile without saving. After closing the browser window, all the profile data will be lost. 2. Save. Save the changes and adds the profile card to the list on the left. 3. Open. Additionally, saves changes to your profile and opens a browser window. Save the profile and now is displayed first at the top in the list of profiles on the left. In the section with profile cards, you can see 1. Current rate. 2. Number of days until the end of the license. 3. Button to hide profile settings and information. 4. Search by profile names. 5. Filter by tags. 6. Sort by alphabetical order, date created or modified. 7. Number of profiles. 8. And the list of profile cards itself. The profile card structure consists of profile names, icons of the operating system and browser, as well as the primary and secondary languages, if it's available. It's possible to pin a profile to the top of the list. Quickly archive your profile and launch the browser. The tags are located just below if they are available. If they are hidden, if there are a large number of tags. The tags themselves can be added both when creating a profile and in the tag manager. The tag manager also allows you to change tags and delete them en masse. To manage a larger number of profiles, a profile manager has been created where you can perform mass actions on profiles, such as removal, adding to the archive, restoring from the archive, import and export, launching the browser. As you can see, even a large number of profiles are launched almost instantly. All this is possible thanks to the local storage of profiles. No information is synchronized and transmitted to the servers except for checking the license. The Undetectable browser is developed on the basis of the Chromium engine and a fully customized interface. At the moment, the set of functions for the browser is quite standard. Search, bookmarks, browsing, and download history. But we are constantly working on new features and performance of the browser to make the work of our users more comfortable and efficient. Another important advantage of the Undetectable browser is the presence of bot. At the moment, the only function added that looks at the list of sites which a specified time to view the page. The function of visiting sites with a random interval of visits, clicks on links on sites, and emulation of mouse movement is already in development. This functionality will be useful for collecting cookies, the so-called warm-up preparation of profiles, for subsequent registration on target sites. Our online service for generating a list of popular sites can help you generate a list of sites. When you register an Undetectable account, you will have access to the entire list of 116 countries and a one-time generation of up to 50 sites per country. What should I do if I need more configurations for a particular system? There is a special configuration store for this purpose, fingerprints.name, where each user is provided with a balance for the purchase of 50 configurations to choose from for free during the beta test period. Each configuration is sold exclusively to one user. After registering on fingerprints.name, in the account settings, you can find the address and token that you can use to connect the program to the store and transfer the purchase configurations to the program.